Hey guys, down for a bit of casting on the M427SU, 125 gram weight and 5500. So a few people were asking me how to start my swing and how to do the swing, so I'm going to try to show it from a few different angles and explain a wee bit, but I'm not even really too sure what to do myself. It just feels quite natural, so I'll do my best to explain it. So the way I sort of started off, I have my back directly to the target. I'm going to do is lay the rod out 270 degrees from where I'm casting, and then throw the lead out and land on the ground. Then when I go to lift the lead up like this, when I go to lift the lead up like that, I sort of swing the weight behind me like that, and then round. Imagine doing like a side swipe sort of cast. So lift it up, out, back. So when I'm doing it, I try to keep my left arm out at all times because I don't really want to. When I push my left out and bring the rod up, I don't want to do that, so I try to swing it out quite flat. It's a wee bit dark looking, so try to brighten up a wee bit. So set my drop, 125 gram, quite long. That's my markers, 150, 125, 100 gram. So lay it out flat, lift the rod up and kind of let the lead swing behind me, and then use that momentum to bring it round. Nearly all done by initial flick. The left hand push out just brings it back a wee bit quicker. So generally, the timing of it is, once I have the lead, once it's swung around and it starts coming back towards me again, once it goes past me, that's when I sort of turn my head and try to leave the rod behind me. I don't really make a conscious decision on thinking of the timing because I have the drop set for different weights, so it always feels the same. So I generally try to start turning the rod, the weight's almost in line with the rod. I'll sort of do a dummy run here and see if I can sort of show it. Sort of thing. And I've seen there as well too, once I turn my head, I try to bring my feet round but keep the rod where it was. I did my right arm come up a wee bit, I don't really want to do that, I want to try to keep the rod low, so I haven't want to re-practice one like that before I do a cast. I'll try one here. Bear in mind it's been 6 or 7 weeks since I've had a proper decent cast, but I'll do a sort of light warm up one here. So once I've done the swing behind me, the leg comes around. Once it passes me, that's when I start turning the head. And then at that point I really try to keep the roll where it is while I get my feet in place. And I really concentrate on feeling that twist in my body. And that's where a lot of the power comes from, the cast, is uncoiling that body. So wait for these people to get out of the way. Remember, safety first. You don't want to get hit with this at 180 mile an hour plus. Right, so we sort of 70% power. So a very common mistake, which I do as well, which a lot of, I've seen a lot of people do, is they bring the rod around the cone. It basically reduces the arc. So on the backswing, if I lift my hand up too high, I end up doing casting like this. See, the rod just comes around the cone. As a result of that, distance goes way down, so I try to keep the rod reasonably low as I can and bring the rod around flatter, but it doesn't always work out that way because you'll see you get a much bigger arc. But then sometimes it can be a trade-off between not hitting the ground and distance. So if you get the rod down low, you don't have to. Loads of casters don't get the rod down low, but you want to try to avoid that cone, I think. If you bring the rod round lower, a nice big, imagine you're following the edge of a CD, nice big arc. Right, let's up the power a bit to about sort of 85, 90%. Alright, right, warm-up's done. Let's give it absolutely 100%. We can sort of see from that, I'd like to bring the rod down lower if I can, so have another couple of casts here before we give it the full welly. Right, try to bring the rod down a wee bit here this time, hopefully not hit the ground, and give it 120% this time. spool slipped. Slime is a bit wet, try to give it full power and the spool slipped. Well, unfortunately, because miles away, because the car park's closed, so I have to walk back to the car. I'm going to be bored fixing that, so that'll do me for today. So hopefully that helped a wee bit, guys. Just looking back at some of those videos here in the car before I go home. Using that 427 there, it's about 14 foot 1, 14 foot 2. It's probably a bit long for me. Cast looks quite slow for 125 gram, even though distance was reasonable. But I think for me, the best length was sort of 13.8, 13.9. But on social media, actually, recently, there's been a lot of talk about going back to shorter rods, because the last several years, rods have just got longer and longer. You know, 13.6, then it was 13.10, then 14.2, and now rods are like some non continental style rods are like 14.10, though, which is ridiculous. So that's another discussion for another day. But for me, I'm going to try to stick around sort of 13.8, 13.9. So maybe I want to get out using the TXL, but I haven't had a chance recently because I've repainted it, but I want to seal it with some Bondo seal first. So till next time, cheers.